Jeffrey Katzenberg, and happy to be here with Empire and the Video Cam Diary at the Cannes Film Festival, 60th anniversary.
Thanks, Jeffrey. On today's Cannes Diary, Jerry Seinfeld creates some buzz for B-movie, handmade films, talk about the Long Good Friday remake, and I almost get mugged by some French kids.
Bonjour, l'internet. I think that's French for bonjour, the internet. And very, very late at the moment. Well, not very late. On our way to a function that I mentioned yesterday. I'll give you a couple of clues. One. Two. Hello, Newman. And three. I'm Jerry Seinfeld. So, yeah, it's Jerry Seinfeld's B-movie. It's 45 minutes of footage being shown today. Chris Rock and Jeffrey Katzenberg are in attendance. So very excited about that. It's obviously Jerry Seinfeld's first foray into feature films. And he's chosen an animated film to do so, which is interesting. And then it's gonna be a lunch thing at the Carlton Beach, during which we'll get to meet the man himself. So very excited about that.
Sadly, the footage indicated that B-movie might be more of a B-minus movie. But afterwards, Seinfeld dressed up as a bee and jumped off the roof of the Carlton Hotel. No, really.
Well, viewers, you wanted A-list A-list stars. We bring you them, dressed as bees.
You know, one thing I hate, Chris, is any kind of movie promotion that smacks of desperation in any way. Well, I like to let the work speak for itself.
Speak for itself.
Well, Jerry, if you don't make it, I just want to say, I never really thought you were that funny.
They told me Scorsese did the same thing last year for Departed. Is that true?
No. You can do it a little more masculine, Jerry. Witness pure stupidity. Ladies and gentlemen, Jerry Seinfeld forgot his keys.
That was Jerry Seinfeld. What was that? Bungee jumping, paragliding, zip gliding, whatever the hell it is. And I take my hat off to him. And that's why he earns a really, really, really big bucks.
Afterwards, there was a beefe at the Carlton Beach. Beefe? Get it? Anyway, Jerry Seinfeld was there. So was DreamWorks animation head honcho Jeffrey Katzenberg. I grabbed him for a quick chat.
DreamWorks come to Cannes every year. Why is this place so important to you guys?
Well, I think on two. There are two things about Cannes. First, there's the film festival itself, which is probably the most distinguished film festival in the world and prestigious. To be invited into Cannes is one of the highest honors that you can have. And I know for the first Shrek movie, when we came here in 2001, it was the first animated movie in 50 years invited into competition. It's a very big deal and a great recognition. Secondly is it's a wonderful marketplace for us to introduce to the international world our movies. And in the old days, there were great showmen who came here and did wonderful stunts. Ilya Salkin with the Superman movies 25 years ago. You know, he took our breath away with flying 25 airplanes out over the Fawzad and doing great stuff. And I had remembered that. And so, you know, we look at this as a place again where, you know, it's an opportunity to introduce our movies in a big way to the world.
You'll probably have read yesterday's announcement that Paul W.S. Anderson is going to remake Long Good Friday. It's a controversial remake. Our cameraman, our mystery cameraman, is enraged by it. Paul's not in Cannes to answer any questions, but we have set up an interview with two members of Handmade Films, the company that made the original and are also remaking. the new movie. It's Guy Collins and Michael Ryan. We're on our way now to the Palais to interview them. And as ever, we're running late.
How all this really came about was that Paul approached us. And at the time he came to us, we were really going down a different path. We were looking at doing a kind of sequel to the original, London-based, possibly involving the same characters, but moving the whole story on, you know, 20, 25 years.
We were going to probably follow Pierce Brosnan from the original movie. Bob Hoskins should have died at the end of the last one, although not necessarily. So the idea was following Brosnan. But Paul came with a completely different take, and it was one that we all fell in love with. He's great. He's a great writer. And he's moved it on. It's present day. It's Miami, exciting city.
Very faithful to the kind of, if you like, the concept of the characters and the events that take place. So there will be similar scenes like the meat processing factory. There'll be scenes like his mum's in a church and his car's blown up. There'll be a kind of nightclub scene. I mean, all those things, but the characters are different. The setting is different. Our central character is Alex, which is short for Alexei. He's a first-generation Russian, so you can work out some aspects of what he's been up to in Miami.
Yeah.
He's not one of the good nicks who came out of Russia when the Iron Curtain came down. He's been a bad guy, and he's now cleaning up his act. He's building a major, huge new casino. He's working or trying to work with Chinese funding, and suddenly, you know, all shit breaks out. I mean, so there's a lot of faithfulness to the original story, but bigger.
Well, that was interesting. You may not entirely agree with Handmaid's decision to remake The Long Good Friday. I know our mystery cameraman certainly doesn't, but you have to admire their moxie. I wish more British production companies and distributors and would come out and just say that the British film industry needs to kick up the backside. And you may not entirely agree with the choice of director, Paul W.S. Anderson, but I remind you, he made Event Horizon, and therefore his place in Valhalla is assured. Well, as you can see, it's just gone 7 o'clock, and the Empire numbers have just swelled by two. Our glorious leader, Mark Dinning, has just arrived, along with our art director, Ian Stevens. In true Empire fashion, they've already buggered off to the boozer, leaving me to attend the UK Film Council's drink stew tonight. And like everything else today, I'm late. Follow me. The party was low-key, but I met a British journalist there who said he'd introduced Steve Martin to Martin Short. Without you, sir, we would never have had the Three Amigos, so thank you. Len, on the way home,
hello,
I made a new friend.
Mum?
Oh, what a lovely little urchin. He's off to rob somewhere, no doubt. Behind me is the Cinema de la Plage, which I believe means cinema on the beach. And it's filling up. I think tonight's the... how definitive this is. I think tonight's the first screening of anything to there. Sailor et Lula, which is the French version of Wild at Heart. So you can have Nicolas Cage going mad in French. He's back again. He's got a friend. I'm scared. I've seen La Haine. I'm getting out of here.